We want to find the area of a circle with radius r, where r is greater than 0. So here we have our circle. So each one of these lengths is r. And here, this point is going to be negative r0. This one is 0, negative r. This point is r0 and 0, r. X squared plus y squared equals r squared, which means that y equals plus or minus the square root of r squared minus x squared. So the area of our circle is going to be the integral from negative r to r of square root of r squared minus x squared minus negative square root of r squared minus x squared. And that integral is with respect to x. So when we simplify our negative signs, we get that this is equal to 2 times the integral from negative r to r of the square root of r squared minus x squared. So we can use our trigonometric substitution. We have r squared minus x squared, so this is like a squared minus x squared. So we can use the substitution that 1 minus sine squared theta equals cosine squared theta. But in this case, we have r squared minus r squared sine squared theta equals r squared cosine squared theta. So back to what our x is. So x equals r times sine of theta, and dx equals r cosine of theta d theta. And we're also going to need to find our bounds in terms of theta, because right now they're in terms of x. So if sine of theta equals x divided by r, then theta equals the inverse sine of x divided by r. And we know that x goes from negative r to r, so that means that inside we're okay with, because on the inverse sine, what's inside has to be between negative 1 and 1. And so since x is going from negative r to r, we're fine. We're going from negative 1 to 1. So that means that we have, plugging everything in, the 2 times the integral from the inverse sine of negative 1 to the inverse sine of 1 of the square root of, we have r squared minus x squared, but x is r sine of theta. So that means we can plug in r squared cosine squared theta. So the square root of r squared cosine squared theta. And dx is r cosine theta d theta. So we have 2 times the integral. To find out what the inverse sine of negative 1 is, think of our unit circle. Remember, we want to know where sine is negative 1. Sine is our y value. So where is our y value negative 1 on the unit circle? It's at negative pi over 2. And where is our sine value 1? That's at pi over 2. It's the square root of r squared cosine squared of theta. That's the absolute value of r times cosine of theta times r cosine of theta d theta. Now, we're going from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So our x values, or our cosine values, are always positive. So that means that we don't have to worry about the absolute value around the cosine, because cosine of theta is always greater than or equal to 0 between pi over 2 and pi over 2. So we get the integral of 2 times the integral from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 of r squared cosine squared theta d theta. We're going to pull out the r squared, that's a constant, so 2r squared times the integral negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 of cosine squared theta d theta. So now we're ready to find the integral of cosine squared of theta. So we can rewrite this using the half angle theorem. We have 2r squared times integral from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 of 1 plus cosine of 2 theta divided by 2. So this is 2r squared times the integral of 1 half theta plus sine of 2 theta divided by 4. And this is going from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So we get 2 times r squared times 1 half times pi over 2 plus sine of 2 times pi over 2, so sine of pi divided by 4, minus 1 half times negative pi over 2 plus sine of 2 times negative pi over 2 is sine of negative pi divided by 4. So we get 2r squared pi divided by 4 plus sine of pi, that little unit circle we drew up here. So sine is our y coordinate. So at pi, sine is 0. So this is 0. We have minus this negative sign. So we have negative and negative makes that a positive. So we have positive pi divided by 4. And sine of negative pi, going up to our unit circle. Negative pi is the same as pi, we're just going around the opposite direction around our unit circle, so that's also 0. So we're left with 2r squared times pi over 4 plus pi over 4, so that is equal to 2r squared times pi over 2, which is just pi r squared.